six groups and six facilitators, there it goes again. And you put up some key words, key messages, key sentences, and I've during the break made a little wordle out of that. Just to show you what were the things mostly discussed. I see giant ESG, of course, in there. There's also top-down, bottom-up. There's responsibility, gender, future, optimistic voices. I really like the end, but when Lenka brought up the student perspective, you'll find students there for sure as well. So I think this is just a nice overview of what has been discussed during the day and gives you the message of this. And I know most of you in this room already work really hard in many of those areas. So my takeaway message would be, when you go home and when I go home, just look at those and maybe work a little bit harder to really make things change and make things happen. So that's my summary of the day, and I'd like to ask Andrew to add on what maybe I could use.
Oh,
perfect.
Okay, my job was to very quickly sum up some of the parallel sessions that took place today. But after 3 days of meetings and very early mornings and late nights and commuting to the program, I've got the concentration span of a mayfly. And I wasn't able to get around all the sessions, so I'm relying on some observations of my colleagues. So I'm afraid this will be quite quick and but there were three parallel sessions, and one of them was Innovation in Higher Education, which discussed the main points of discussion for a system of sustainability in higher education, including assessment from a variety of perspectives, students, research, policy makers, participation, mutual learning, and students' active participation. Another of the parallel sessions was regional and institutional case studies. And the main points that came out of that were different examples of how universities institute sustainability and where the success factors are, which include recognizing and welcoming diversity, empowerment, leadership, relevance to engage partners from society, and practically oriented approaches. And then with the final parallel session, which I did actually observe, but I got there a bit late, which was teaching the teachers, which was brilliantly facilitated by Jeff. And some of the issues that came out when I came late were definitions of ESD, and with Jeff making the observation that in Australia it includes social, economic, environmental, cultural aspects. So not just the three pillars, but the fourth pillar. And making sure we all understand a common set of meanings of what ESD means. Helping people, because Jeff was coming, of course, from a assessment perspective, since that's the focus of his work. So he talked about helping people with learning, and especially what engages young people in productive learning, such as whether it's relevant to them, relevant to me, whether their peer group is involved in it with them. We also talked about eco-ethical thinking as a starting point for human relationships to the environment. And then at the end, Jeff gave a condensed version of what he would normally have delivered in about 1 hour. And he delivered it very well in about 5 minutes by flicking through all the slides. I won't say that. I'll do it myself. But really, there was some very, very interesting slides, and if you get the opportunity, and I'm sure we'll all share our presentations via the Copernicus website or via an email, but if you get the opportunity, do have a look at Jeff's presentation, because it's extremely interesting. And the highlight for me that came out of it was looking at a bit of personal, interpersonal cognitive capabilities combined with role-specific and generic competencies. And there was this one slide that looked at capabilities. There are 12 out of 38 capabilities that are defined by 9 employers, I believe. Looking at what capabilities are conceived of in the real world, in the workplace by employers, which were not aligned with what is assessed in universities, completely divorced from what assessment is in universities. So universities, workers these days, employers these days talk about being work ready or work ready plus. And Jim has made the observation that a lot of what we've been talking about today has been about the plus, which includes concepts being sustainability literate, change implementation savvy, being creative and inventive, with an emphasis on ethical entrepreneurship, and having one's own ethical position. So just to reiterate, if you do get a chance to see that presentation, do have a look at it. Thanks.
Great. Thank you very much, Andrew. And I hope that gives you sort of an overview of what has been happening during the day in the different sessions and different rooms. And now I'd like to again thank all the people, all the institutions who've been involved, and of course, particularly the Copernicus Alliance. And I'd like to invite Clemens Smarter, the Vice President of Copernicus Alliance, to tell a few closing words.
Thanks for this short time of words, for the opportunity for this short for words. And I've also done a very short kind of wrap up of what has come together today, bringing very fruitful discussions and presentations also, either from the panel as well as from the plenary sessions. And so just I've put together some thoughts about those issues that came together. I'd also only talk about 5 minutes about it, but talking about sustainability transformation nexus, so something that brings together actually an opportunity how transformation can take place. Then about leadership and innovation, a topic that came up through plenty of discussions actually during the day, and then also assessment of sustainability in higher education. I had the impression that it is really something that Texas people and people care about and try to improve in the future. And finally, just some points of where to go, so what can we do for the future, and what can we work on. So this is actually this nexus, and this nexus we have worked on in the course of a research project, where we were looking about, okay, what different aspects of transformation actually come together when we talk about sustainability transformation. This research project, system modeling, we found out it's very crucial to have research, education on the one point, policy institutions and policy being involved, and on the other point, society and economy, to have actively involved in transformation processes. So of course, as higher education institutions, we can now find ourselves in here, and we think about, okay, through RCEs, through society interactions, through transdisciplinary research and so on, how can we work actually in this nexus together with other people? And being here in this conference, we were very much talking and having it as the main focus theme of the day, talking about education for sustainable development. This is actually where education for sustainable development can take place. Not only within the higher education institution, not only in society, but really in the nexus of the three to implement transformation for sustainable development. Looking into this a bit closer, it is what we have talked today also, and what Daniela also brought up and brought examples for it also. It is about changing paradigms. It is also about thinking higher education outside of the box. The Rio Plus 20 higher education treaty for sustainable development in its first principle actually says to be transformative, higher education needs to transform itself. So we need to think about, okay, how do we transform our institutions from within? And here then just some snapshots where we've talked today about in different fields of education, policy and society where transformation actually for sustainable development can take place. In education and research, we were talking about professional development of university educators, University Educators for Sustainable Development Project. That many of us here in this room are actually part of, really pushes the idea of building capacities and competences of educators on ESG issues. I brought up the idea of this again, research into policy and practice, and it is very crucial to mention that it, that it should also go vice versa. So it should be a real dialogue perspective of cooperating between research and education institutions with policy and practice. So we talk about inter- and transdisciplinary research as well as also education through new innovative forms of educational programs that we have also read a lot about today in our different sessions. And we talk about the whole of the institution approach, where really the whole institution works together, together with society, on informing change of higher of the institution itself. From the policy perspective, we have heard about an interesting speech about the UNEC initiatives in addressing policy for educators' competences on ESG, as well as also showing up that the national and regional implementation of ESG policy is very important. There was this example in Germany where ESG is actually being implemented in research programs. From a policy perspective also, it is very important to mention the Global Action Program on ESG that we now follow up in mandating on education for sustainable development. And I will come closely further into that more closely. And from a society perspective as well, thinking higher education outside than the average hour, outside the box, and looking into opportunities how we actually actively can contribute and cooperate, co-create together with society transformation towards sustainable development. The second point was leadership and innovation in higher education for sustainable development. We have discussed about shaping futures through higher education institutions, shaping futures from today on, taking action for it. It is very much also about engaging the disengaged people, where we might find ourselves within a group of people that are very much engaged in ESG issues, but we need to find opportunities actually to engage also people who we couldn't attract so long. Therefore, we need to enable actually leadership for ESG and for sustainable development within our institutions. To enable this leadership among faculty, students, society on an equal level. Therefore, we could also talk about the kind of whole of people approach, yeah? Where we really bring all of the different kinds of people together and to take leadership and action agency for sustainable development and ESG. Therefore, we need to understand complex and uncertain systems, wherefore we work on ESG programs within our universities and in society. But it also needs some actually assessment for sustainable development and ESG within our institutions. But there is a question about what is really important within our institutions. There are different values, perceptions and perspectives coming together of what is important and what is, would be the notion of quality actually in higher education. So we can question this and think about new opportunities and ways of assessing sustainability within our institutions. Therefore, there is a need of actually an integrative and individually adapted assessment approach. And today, plenty of different approaches have been integrating sustainability practices into education and training environments, which is meant as a whole of institution approach. It is about increasing the capacity of educators and training. So we are already very active in the university educators program through within this field. And it is about encouraging either youth as well as community and municipal authorities to develop community-based ESD programs. We will meet together again within the University Educators for Sustainable Development program. Many of us will do so, and all others are also invited to meet and exchange with us in this conversation tonight to learn about the program and to learn about the opportunities to raise awareness for ESD among educators and to foster ESD among professional development programs for ESD within our institutions. And last but not least, I'd like to mention you are all very much invited to join the Copernicus Alliance. Copernicus Alliance is a very open network of higher education institutions for sustainable development, and we would very much invite you to join us, yes, to together establish new initiatives, new programs, new activities, find new opportunities for common research and practice. So we would be happy if you would join us also for future conferences and the network itself. So thank you very much, all of you, for your very active participation. And of course, thank you very much to the Johnson University team for the very nice and wonderful organization of the conference. Thank you, Chiri, Diana, Dana, and Andrew for your very active support. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. And I think that we are really at the end of the conference, and still I would like to really thank one person, and this is Dana. Dana, here you are. The others, you are only helping her. And so, I think that still there is some time for you, at least your dinner, to enjoy Prague. The weather is now today very nice. Little bit you can still look for the Charles University. You are in the place where the Charles University was founded 666 years ago, 1348. And you are in the very historical part of city Prague, so look around and come again to Prague and see you at the dinner.
Yes, excellent. I have mine, which is the worst. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you. And I have three pieces of information for you, actually, so this is perfect. So regarding the presentations, you can ask all the speakers share your presentations and we'll put them up on the website of the conference. So, you know, we'll ask people if they're happy to share it. If they are, you can download the presentations. Second piece of information, when you're walking out of the room now, if you don't need your badge anymore, please leave it in the box there so that we can reuse it again, you know, resource efficiency. So that's the second thing. And third is, if you're coming to dinner tonight, you have a dinner voucher, a dinner ticket in your folder. Please bring it with you because we have a vegetarian standard menu, so it will be easier for the waitresses when they're serving the food to find out who actually should be getting what. And we'll be meeting either 6:45 in front of the main entrance to go to the dinner, or if you think you can find the place yourself, that's 7 p.m. directly at the restaurant. It's called Kolkovna Salmita. It's in your pack. There's a map as well, so you shouldn't have a problem from you. And enjoy your, if you're not coming with us, enjoy your evening and looking to back home.